After 12 years on patrol in the northwest of England, Sonia Hume's passion for wildlife is as strong as ever.
The interaction with animals is definitely one of the reasons that I love working for the RSPCA. Being able to see things that people in a lifetime would never see. It's just, yeah, it's an absolute privilege to be able to get that close to our native wildlife.
We've had a caller that found a baby hedgehog at 5 years ago. Thinks he might have been hit by a car.
Tell her to send it to me.
Hedgehog numbers in the UK have halved since the year 2000 to less than 1 million. Loss of habitat and fewer insects to eat mean many young hoglets are left orphaned.
We're putting up fencing around our gardens. The hedgerows aren't there anymore. They are declining. It's becoming really, really difficult for them.
Hiya, RSPCA, come for the hedgehog.
Yeah.
See you there. Come on,
he
dog.
Is, yeah, he was just up the road here. He's on this main road.
On the main road.
Yeah.
No sign of any others.
We've wrapped him all up warm.
You're gorgeous, aren't you?
There's no way I would have left him.
They're endangered, these
guys.
Because there's not many of them left anymore.
I've never seen one that small myself.
Have you not? They're even smaller than that when they're born.
We wouldn't have had a chance, really, would it?
No. Was he out during the day, was it?
Yeah.
It could be that he's orphaned, because he shouldn't really be out in the daytime at all, let alone on his own.
It could be that his mum had been killed by, I don't know, maybe a lawnmower, got caught, or maybe she'd been run over.
Sometimes, if anything's happened to the mum, if she's injured or unfortunately she's died,
then they
come out and start looking for food. Hey.
The orphaned hoglet is very small. Sonia needs to get him to the wildlife centre.
We'll hand rear him, we'll get him eating and drinking some, put him on some milk.
He's too young to fend for himself, but he needs to build up fat and strength if he's ever to survive in the wild. In Cheshire, it's been a month since a small orphaned baby hedgehog arrived at the wildlife centre. It was touch and go, but with round-the-clock care, he's still alive. Vet Beth Panto is monitoring his progress.
They're nocturnal, so he's asleep in the day, which is a good sign.
He's curling up into a ball, which is good. Nice to see that he's not too tame.
With wildlife this young, there's an ongoing dilemma for Bev and the Wildlife Centre staff.
With young animals, if you spend too much time around them, then they can actually start imprinting on us or becoming tame, at which point we won't be able to release them.
If the animal is too tame to release, then sometimes the only humane thing to do is to put it to sleep.
It's a real challenge with wildlife to actually work out exactly how much to intervene. So let's give a quick check. Checks are really important, and you can't take anything for granted. When you release them into the wild, that's it, they're gone. You don't have a second chance. His spines all look normal, he's not showing any signs of skin disease, and that he's in good body condition. So we'll just pop him on the scales.
The hedgehog weighed just 135 grams when it was rescued, less than a tennis ball.
341 grams, which is a good gain. Comparing back to when he first came in, he's so much bigger. So we're probably going to wait till he's at least 450, so he's still got another 100 grams or so to go.
The baby hedgehog needs fat stores to hibernate through a winter in the wild.
Going to be here a little bit longer, I'm afraid.
With nearly a quarter of his release weight still to gain, his future is still uncertain.
Right, let's have a look at this little hedgehog. There she is, look at the size of her.
Oh, massive. Hi, Mrs.
Hi.
Yeah, stop trying to prickle me. They have a defence mechanism, and when you pick them up and they're a bit scared, they tend to bounce a little bit, and it's just to try and get you with the prickles. And you can probably just see that bobbing. So she's trying to prickle you. Get off me. Are you coming out and saying hello? Hey, she's a bit camera shy, I think. and coming out. She's having a sniff. It's like, what's going on? She's got a really tight grip. It's amazing how strong the grip is on your fingers. Come on, can I have my hand back? Thank you. When we first got her, she weighed 135 grams. She fitted in the palm of my hand. Since she's been in, she's put on 400 grams since we've had her. So tonight's the night we're gonna let go and we're gonna take her back to where she came from. Shall we pop you in the box? I'm just hiding the paper. Come on then, missus. Off on a mission.
Sonia has waited till dusk to give this nocturnal creature the best possible return to the wild.
Come here, missus. Ah, you're a prickly beast, aren't you? Well, there you go. Are we ready? Let's put you back. This area's perfect. It's really open, so you should be able to find food here, and there's loads of trees and undergrowth that she can hide in. Absolutely couldn't be a better place to let her go. Shall we put you down, missus? She's like, oh, grass. This is different. Hey. What a good sniff, kid. She was that little when she came in. She won't remember what the outside is, what grass is. So it's all different smells for her. Can hear her licking her lips. It's brilliant to see that. You never see it. Lying on her side and her spitting on her back, on her spine, that's self-anointing. They say it's usually a sign that something's to remember a pleasurable experience. There you go. It's bad to see it on camera because you don't see this very often. Go on, you need to move forward and then we can go. I can go and have my tea. Couldn't have asked for any better, really. It's lovely.